Good afternoon, everybody. I am Tawan and I have been serving this department for 2 years. Now I like to discuss Quantiki, which is an operating system for wireless sensor network and its simulator known as QGIS. Quantiki. First of all, I like to discuss Quantiki operating system, which is developed by Adam Daniels in 2002. Further, it was developed by various teams, means various academic bodies and institutes like Campbell, Cisco, Artin University, Oxford University. Obviously, the teams were led by Adam Daniels, and it's built for the resource constrained environment, means we can recall that all the operating systems are not built for the same purpose. Operating systems for conventional laptop PC. Operating systems for smartphones are not same because their underlying hardware are not same, nor the demand for the services are same. That's why operating system for wireless sensor network is not same as conventional operating system. It has to take up lots of challenges like processing speed of the microcontroller, limited bandwidth of communication, memory capacity, and power supply. Power supply is a very important issue for wireless sensor network because sometimes the sensor nodes are dropped to some areas where battery recharging and replacement everything is nearly impossible. So this type of issues are incorporated in the operating system, that is different from conventional approach. And it's an open source, means we can download the OS at free of cost, we can study, we can modify it, we can develop it without bothering about any kind of copyright or legal permission. Now, so far I have divided my discussion into four parts. Some fundamental aspects of Quantiki. Next, a comparative study between Quantiki and TinyOS, which is the computer of Quantiki. And now, introduction to QGIS simulator and a simple test message transmission between two nodes. For the time being, we haven't considered any complicated network or any routing protocol, just a simple message transmission. Next, a transmission of a multimedia. And for this time, we have taken image as a multimedia, but we can analytically show other types of multimedia files can also be transmitted in simulated version. Now, fundamentals of Quantiki. Fundamental of an OS or Quantiki like OS itself is huge and complicated, but still I like to focus on some important zones of it. Hardware for Quantiki is very lightweight. Means initially it was built for 10 KB RAM without graphical user interface, but later it was when graphical user interface is considered, it is extended for 20 KB, but this size is not standard. It was still developing, new features are being incorporated, but nearly or in a nutshell, this field in a very Quantiki has a special module for multitasking. When it is integrated with Quantiki, it can support multitasking environment. It was specially built for the embedded system. And RIME is another type of protocol stack, which is for radio communication only. But there are some situations where use of RIME is much more preferred compared to MICRO-IP because it produces much overhead. And any application can directly use MICRO-IP, RIME, or both. And even RIME and MICRO-IP can call their services together. Now, this paper covers the detail of RIME protocol. I am not going to the detail because it's a demo session. Just we need some theoretical background. It is made of some communication primitives like single hop, unicast, multi hop, unicast, single hop, broadcast. Primitives are nothing but a lightweight protocol. So, any application developer has the freedom to combine those primitives into a complicated protocol, then use it. So any application can use primitive complicated protocol or the elements of the stack directly. Now quantity processes are known as proto-threads. These are nothing but some lightweight stackless threads. Stackless means whenever in a multi-threading environment a thread is to be allocated, its corresponding stack space is to be allocated. But proto-thread does not need any stack space. Only one stack is shared among multiple threads. And contiguous kernel is event-based, means whenever a particular event occurs, it triggers a process to execute. And this kind of proto-thread is better than conventional multi-threading because it saves memory for stack space. And for wireless sensor network like the device or system where memory is very very restricted, memory is limited, this type of facility can obviously provide some sort of advantages. Now, a comparative study between TinyOS and Quantiki. These two are the popular operating system for WSL. In some aspects, Quantiki and TinyOS are similar, in some aspects they are different. TinyOS suits better when resource is very very limited. Quantiki is also built for resource limited environment, but still Quantiki performs better, or better to say outperforms TinyOS. Well, flexibility is the issue. Means entire thing is not to be worked on, just a part of the thing is to be worked on. It's part of the module or part of the job or part of a kernel is to be compiled this way. Now we'll study them side by side. Kernel architecture, first of all. TinyOS kernel is monolithic. It's made of several layers. Top layer calls the services of bottom layer. In this way, layer prepares a static image of a kernel and the kernel is loaded into operating system. TinyOS doesn't have any facility of dynamic loading. That's why kernel is expected to be bigger. But on the other hand, Quantiki supports modular kernel, it has dynamic loading facility. Means kernel is divided into several modules, and if a module is required, that is placed into memory. If it is no longer required, it is removed from the memory. If it is again required, brought back into the memory. So this type of dynamism is allowed, that helps to work on a reduced space. Programming model for Quantiki and TinyOS both are event driven, but primarily TinyOS didn't have any support for multi-threading, but later some thread facilities have been included for TinyOS. These threads are known as QoS threads, but these are backward compatible with the earlier version of TinyOS. These threads obviously require some memory like other threads. But there is one disadvantage for TinyOS threads is that a program has to explicitly assign the concurrency of those threads. But for proto threads, we have already said that it has some blocking and unblocking system for so that it can maintain concurrency. User don't have to worry about it, call currency. And it's event driven, both of the cases I have just already discussed. Now, whenever an event arrives, it is put to a queue, and finally those events are fetched from the queue, it will trigger an event handler, in turn it will execute a process. This is the basic mechanism for the both of the ways, but extraction mechanism from the queue for tinyOS is non-primitive FIFO, but for quantity it is priority based. Now, tinyOS supports virtualization of a resource. An actual resource, from actual resource, multiple copies of virtual resources are prepared and then they can be used. But there are some shareable resources which cannot be virtualized, like some part of the network protocol. Then a process has to wait for the completion of the process which is holding that part. But continuous other sort of mechanism for serializing resources, it does not use virtualization. Memory arrangement for quantity is static, just as told earlier, but it has some memory protection issues like tracking pointers, like tracking down array errors. But dynamic memory management is the key issue for quantity. Dynamic memory management means dynamic linking and loading. Say, if part of the kernel is affected, it needs to be recompiled or needs to be debugged, then entire kernel is not used. Then that part is to be worked on. That is the key feature of dynamic memory management and quite advantageous compared to tinyOS. But it doesn't have any address protection mechanism. tinyOS uses single level file system, means within the same directory all files are created, and as for the application of tinyOS, this is sufficient. But quantity doesn't have any such kind of hierarchical restriction. It uses a kind of file system known as copy. It uses a micro log or a kind of smaller log by operating system, and that size of the log can be set by the user. Additionally, it has some other advanced facilities. Now, communication protocol for quantity is an active message. I don't know the detail, but somehow message arrives. Whenever message arrives, it reads the message, processes the message, and finally sends the message. And for quantity, it's micro and write protocol, just I have already mentioned. A kind of security module is developed for tinyOS known as tinySec, but its equivalent version for quantity is quantitySec, but still it is under the proposal, not developed yet. Simulator for tinyOS network simulator is TOSIN, whereas network simulator in tinyOS is PUJA. Now in our demo we will show some operations in PUJA. Whenever we have to write any application in tinyOS, we have to use NestC, which is nothing but a dialect of C or a variation of a C, but in tinyOS it supports only C language. These are the steps of code development. First of all, we need to ensure that its connection is properly made or not. Connection with the hardware and OS, where we are going to develop an application. Then we have to remove the hardware. Next, we can develop an application logic inside a simulated environment. And finally, we can test and debug using PUJA. PUJA is a simulator for tinyOS, just I have already told. Before loading directly into a hardware, we can simulate inside the artificial environment and try to reduce its limitation as much as possible. And finally, whenever code is almost up to the mark, that is loaded into the target application hardware. One thing I like to mention that PUJA has a special kind of mode known as PUJA, that name is also PUJA, which is fully simulated, which does not require any hardware, just it has some artificial environment, and instead of memory it uses file system, like that, it it is fully simulated and just used for logic synthesis and research purpose. Now, why do we want to use quantity? Because it is built for the low power devices, or better to say, so limited resource devices. Conventional operating system cannot take up challenge like this. And its kernel is modular kernel. It has some dynamic loading and linking facility, I have just already mentioned. So it's much more flexible compared to TiOS. Now it is developed using C language. C is the mother of all programming languages, you know that. So that's why growth of development is expected to be rapid. It's built on well-tested protocol. And finally, many teams across the world is working on it. Many masterminds have already put their effort, and many contributions are going on. Especially it is open source, and there are lots of quantity developers forum also present. Now, coming to the practical issue, how to install quantity. Since it is an OS, to run it inside another OS as an application, we need virtual box or virtual machine, better to say. And these are two popular virtual machines, VMware player or virtual box. I prefer VMware player, but virtual box can be an alternative. And quantity image file that will be loaded into the virtual machine, VMware, that will be played like a RRS file system, like songs or like that. And we can play an operating system inside another operating system. Now, little later, after the end of PPT, I will show a demo of message passing between sender node and receiver node. This is the text message passing. I haven't considered any complicated network architecture or any routing protocol, just a simple text message passing, just the fundamental issues. But later, and issue of image transmission. Transmission of a text message between two nodes is very easy, but transmission of an image is comparatively difficult because it's not the same thing. It's not only huge, it has some other complications. Why? Because in MATLAB, there is a special dedicated function in read or in write that uses file length and finally produces pixel array. But in C language, it's not so easy to read an image. And moreover, image cannot be loaded entirely. Why? Say I'm working on 200 by 200 bitmap RESTful image. 200 by 200 means it has 40,000 pixels. Since it is a grayscale, intensity lies between 0 to 255, so 8 bit is required to represent it. So 1 byte for 1 pixel. So near about 40,000 bytes exactly, and like 35 kb or like that. But that amount of memory cannot be affordable by Pooja. That's why we have to load it part by part. Besides, it has header, color table, other information. To process image, it requires some further memory allocation. So it has some sort of complication. And whenever image is loaded, a part of the image is loaded and it has to be processed without knowing, having the entire image. Just we have to set up a logic between the entire image and then part. That will be a difficult image processing issue. And pixel array position, if MATLAB provides, it's exactly as we assume. But for C language, if I just try to extract the pixel array, it's not the same as we logically think. It's totally upside down. Means 00 location, this is the first top left pixel, it resides somewhere else. This is the mapping that helps to find the shift from the beginning of the pixel array. For example, if it is 00, then if we put R, means row equal to 0 and column equal to 0, it will be h minus 1 multiplied by w. H represents height, whereas W represents width. So it will be height minus 1 multiplied by W. So this amount of shift is required from the magnitude of the fixed error to get actual geodesic location. So if I modify according to the fixed error available, then the modification will be reflected somewhere else. So this is a challenge, and the thing will be much more visible if we work on color image, because color image has three components per picture, and this mapping will be not the exactly same as we think. So there are, we have to read a particular part of the image. This part is known as macro block. This term is standard, means it's nothing but a collection of pixels. For the time being, we just have shown the pixels of this region. This is brought into the memory, then it is processed again, it will be sent as a packet or not. And not only that, simply sending an image in wireless transmission, we know that energy consumption depends on amount of data sent from the sender. So sometimes we need to exclude the some unimportant parts. We need to block some macro blocks. We need to mask some macro blocks. We have to say not sending only the important jobs. That's why we can put some condition in it that this block this macro block or allow others macro blocks like that. It can lead to a lightweight segmentation algorithm, but this will add some processing overhead. So this type of issues have to be considered. In our demo, I will show to transfer of an entire image and finally followed by blocking a part of the image depending on some condition. Okay?
Which part of the image is treated as unimportant?
That requires our algorithm. That requires to build an algorithm. For a particular image, maybe there exists that important part in it must be well defined in the middle part of the zone. So somehow I exclude the upper part and lower part this way. But this is not the convention, right? It depends on the application. Somehow we have to build a lightweight segmentation algorithm to segment important and non-important zone, or we have to put some condition. I will show that some arbitrary condition that will block some part, but later we can plan for blocking some non-important zones. Now this is the demo I am expecting to show. Now these are some useful links where we can get some documentary assistance of quantity, and source code is downloadable at the site. So source code is freely available, so we don't have to bother about it. Now the demo part. Just I told that we need virtual machine player and quantity image file. Okay. So whenever VMware player is set up, this yellow logo appears on the screen. This logo. Okay. I have already set up this software, but if it is not, then we need to set it. Okay. Now, just I am clicking on it. So it has four options. We can create new virtual machine, we can open an existing virtual machine file, we can upgrade to virtual machine workstation. Workstation means there will be lots of virtual machine that will not be, this is not a non-commercial usage, this is commercial actually. We have to pay for it, but we can have the facility to upgrade, then lots of virtual machine will run at a time. And we can also configure some client server architecture around that. But we are not interested to it, just only three versions will serve our purpose. Now, since we have from open virtual machine, we can connect with the virtual machine file that are stored in g:quantiki2.6 in this folder. But whenever this file is available, we can connect it, and after connection, this logo will appear. Okay, logo of this line actually, this item. Instant quantity 2.6. This is the virtual machine. Now we need to play. It requires some time. Now we have to type password. This is the Pooja simulator. Now go to file, new simulation. After this demo there will be a practice session. If somebody is interested, you have seen a join in our lab. Okay. Create new simulator. Simulation name can be anything of our choice. But radio media, there are five types of radio media. First of all is unit disk graph model, graph medium, distance loss, constant loss, directed graph radio medium, no traffic, multiple. There are many types of mathematical models under it. Unit disk graph model is actually graph is nothing but a set of vertices and edges, we know. And unit disk graph model considers equiradius circles. Circle has some centers. Those centers are nothing but they are resembles two vertices, and two vertices will be connected. Or if there will be an edge, if the distance lies between a particular threshold value, and that situation is exactly similar to a wireless sensor network, because when sensor node is dropped, it has certain location, it has certain transmission ranges. If sensors are homogeneous and transmission range is supposed to be omnidirectional, then it will be equivalent to a unit disk graph model. But it has two varieties. One is distance loss and constant loss. Constant loss means if any node lies within a circle, then or transmission range, then it will receive the packet. Otherwise, it will not receive any packet. But for distance loss, it is an extended version of constant loss. Means if a node lies within a transmission range, it will receive packet with certain probability. For other models, means directed graph medium, it will explicitly assign user to use some asymmetric graph. And node radio traffic means a kind of model where radio traffic is not present, means whenever communication is not going on, then it will turn off the radio traffic. That will save processing time. And for multipath ray tracer medium, it follows ray model. Like whenever ray propagates, it has some reflection, refraction, or attenuation due to obstacle. This type of features are incorporated. However, we switch on to the simplest model. Distance loss, it can be simulated using constant loss model also. Now, finally, we have to create. Create means creating one simulation. Now, we will go to mode. This is the next step. Add modes. Create new mode. There are lots of modes, but apart from Puja mode, other modes are directly related to hardware. Means we need a real hardware to be connected. But for Puja mode, you know, it is purely simulated, so we will work on Puja mode for the time being. Now, we need to load program. Program is already prepared for demo purpose. Just within a demo folder that is not by default present. I have kept it in example directory, 20 example like that. If you need to develop a program, you have to create a directory inside that example and then you have to put your file. And there are some corresponding changes also made. Say this file is responsible for unicasting between two nodes, unicast communication. Now I have loaded this file. Next thing is to compile. When compilation is successfully done, then create. This window provides us option to create how many modes, according to the position that is related to the deployment of those modes, some each attribute related to position means their positional relation means what will be the interval between these. There are lots, some opportunities, random positioning, linear positioning, elliptical, manual positioning, but we have selected random positioning for the timing, but for unicasting at least two nodes are required, more than two will be the sufficient. First node is not visible, that's why we need to zoom out. This is the way. Now, if we put the radio environment on, then we can see its transmission range by a green circle. Okay. And if we zoom out again, then we have the option, we can clearly see that there are two concentric circles, one is green, another is gray. Gray represents interference range, but these ranges can be altered. There is an option for it. Just if we right click, then if we click transmission ranges, then we can change their ranges. Like this. Transmission range is default set to 50 meter and interference range. So if I like to modify it, say interference range, I like to modify for 80. Transmission range I like to modify for say 70. And this is the scenario. So it depends on our application. What will be the transmission range, what will be the interference range of a particular mode. This is totally simulated, that's why these features are customizable. Now, there are four windows, actually we can see. First, this is the network window. Before deploying a node, it was empty, but whenever we deploy nodes again and again, it will be gradually filled up. And this is simulation control window, means we can control our simulation, means we can start simulation, we can pause for a while. This way, we can reload any simulation, we can observe the simulation step by step.
mode output window means if we like to print something from a mode, means printing is required before sending a data or after receiving a data, if the data transmitted properly or not to check. So this is, there are some purpose where we can print something from a mode. So those printed data will appear on this mode window. On this mode window. And this is the timeline window. That shows the radioactivity. Means sometimes it will be blue, sometimes it will be green. Blue represents transmission, green represents reception. So a particular mode, if it is receiving, it will be green, blue for the time being. This way, there are certain windows for some operation. Now, since 2 is within the transmission range and the program is tuned in such a way that 1 can send data to 2 or one can send node to other nodes, but this condition can be changed later. Let us observe start. Actually, if we turn on the radio traffic, we can see that transmission of data by a blue arrow. This is the way. 2 transmits 1. And what is being transmitted, that will be recorded in mode output window. Means, if we gradually elaborate it. See, mode 1, it receives unicast message from that is printed inside the file. I like to show it. This is the demo folder where actually program this is. This function static void receive UC, it receives an unicast message and do something. What is to be done, that is written inside it. It's clearly shows that unicast message received from, this is the way to represent that message. And it's clearly printing the data. And what is data? That is specified in the process state. This is the operation that is processing in mode is doing apart from receiving. This is the execution part of the mode. That while one means there is an infinite loop, it receives, it copies hello message to the buffer. This file represents size of the message in bytes. Since hello is a composed of 5 characters, it is 5. This way we are sending hello from 1 and that is received by 2 node. Unicast message received from node 2. 2 is actually sending and 1 is receiving. The arrow indicates from 2 to 1. The program can be changed according to the our target. Now this is a simple text message transmission. We can also work with multiple nodes to check what is happening. now remove. We have to create a new simulation. All our steps are just as before. Continue process. Try another mode. One mode is to make the simulation. Five blocks with random position. Please note. The way of data transfer. The program can be altered according to our requirement. But this kind of simulation is possible. In mode output window, we have the output gradually. Transmission of an image. Say I am going to transmit this image. This image will be captured by the source node and finally it will be transmitted. And at high-end receiver node, that will be received. And finally, using high-end configuration, we have implemented it using Mendeley. For high-end configuration, we can reproduce the image. If we like to block a part of the image, then that part will appear as darker. So this is the image, say I am going to save. We need two files. Because these two files were, I have developed application. If our application is new, then new file is required. .c means source file. Source node means the node is which is capturing. We are not using real sensor since we are using file system. So we have to read one file from the disk. That is the simplest logic. So this is the file name, sendimg.pmt. Probably this name is same as this file name. sendimg.pmt. Okay. So you have to supply the file name. There is some complicated code. For the time being, actually, this is the condition I have put. When theoretical discussion was going on, I just described that we need to transmit one macro block. This is some collection of pixels. A part of the image is to be loaded into the memory and finally processed and transmit. That macro block has some collection of pixels. For the timing, we have just used 4x4 macro block, means 16 pixels, which is denoted by the position of its topmost pixel, top left means suppose 4x4 means first row there will be 4 pixels, in next row there will be 4 pixels. The first pixel has some position with respect to the global image pixel array. Its row number and column number represent that macro block. So this time, we are not blocking any part of the image. Our intention is to send the entire image. So, we will remove the condition. You see, Sync is a high-end receiver. Just a second note, in our simplest example, this is the text file where we are catching up intensities. Say its name is transmitted_new.txt. Now again, we will go to mode and and mode series. We'll deploy fast node for sync, for high-end receiver. Then next type of node is for source node. See, source and sync has different types of functions, so we cannot load same function into both of them. Now let us start simulation. See, in simulation control window, in mode output window, we have the intensity transmitted and along with the macro blocks. This is the name number for macro block. These are the intensities of a macro block. We have 16 intensities, and these are the name of macro block. Name means the position of the top left of each macro block. That is transmitted and into the file, and node 2 actually it receives and puts into a file transmitted dot txt. new.txt, like that name, and that will be reconstructed by high level programming using MATLAB. We'll see later. Just check now for the time being that if the file is created or not inside demo directory, because we have set the location for the destination file in demo directory. This is the file actually, but those intensities are transmitted. Now next job is to block a part of the image. Means we will work on the condition. What does it mean by R greater than equal to C? if it is a fixed cell array, then R greater than equal to C means it will block the upper triangular matrix. Is it like that? Upper triangular matrix of the fixed cell array. Those macro blocks will not be transmitted. Rest of the macro blocks will be transmitted. So check, first create the file, you will check at a time, after it. These simulations are very time consuming actually. File name is same, we are working on same image, but destination file name must be different because we are using append mode, otherwise those intensities will be appended into the previous file. Let us name it transmitted 2.txt. Again, we have to start a new simulation. More steps are just as before. Now let us start simulation before starting simulation. Check once again if the names are okay or not. If I put condition, yes. At the mode output we know. Will have those pixel array have been transmitted. But we have put one condition, R greater than or equal to C, then it will be transmitted. You will never find R which is less than C throughout the simulation. Now check if the file is created or not. This is terminated new to file is created. Now again another put another condition. We will work on three conditions. These three are sufficient for our understanding. No longer required. Inside UC source, let us two condition are not equal to C. When blocks, metro blocks along the diagonal will not be same. Remember, we have to maintain this kind of mapping because diagonal means it will be somewhere else in the organization because actually fixed array is upside down. That complicated mapping is incorporated into the scoring system. Let us rename the file or put another name for it. Let's see, transmitted new3.txt, this is the name. Again, we have to declare two modes. Now let us start simulation. The red indicates simulation is over. Now check that there is no metro block where R equal to C because we have put the condition R not equal to C. There is no metro block where row number and column number match. Now check if the file is created or not. Transmitted new3.txt. Now we are in a phase to reconstruct those images. If those images are properly reconstructed at the receiver end or not, we will check. I am just copying three files instead of this dragging. You can use copy. just there is a folder in our desktop demo. It contains an image. We have certain MATLAB files, and from that MATLAB we locate that folder or the directory where we will be keeping this file. That is not mandatory for every application, just for our application. Using MATLAB, because whenever data is transmitted at the receiver, we don't no longer record the process in the simulator. We can do it using high-end computation. Now locate that part. Inside image, we have kept these three files, and I have designed a code that is responsible for converting that transmitted file into an image. For the time being, I just put the fast file name. Now run. This is the image, the entire image, because transmitted new TXT is expected to gather up all data from image, all pixel data. Now it's very interesting if I type transmitted new 2.txt, because we put condition R greater than equal to C. So upper triangle is expected to be not present. See. This area, this dark region represents there is no data. So we can put any condition or any live rate segmentation algorithm before sending it. We can block a part of the region based on our application. Now check if our strategy runs or not is a third example. The condition was R not equal to C, which diagonal macro blocks are expected to be absent. This dark region, these macro blocks are not present. They are not transmitted from the source. That's why this is the dark.